The last decade has been a roller coaster ride for the Japanese car maker in India. The same manufacturer who introduced us to the start-stop button through the Micra. Not that the cars were bad, but they failed to understand the changing consumer behavior. This, coupled with the limited service network, was exactly how a car cannot sell well in India. The word magnite is derived from the Japanese word kubuko, which means game changer. Can the magnite live up to its name? We are here in Chennai to find that out for you. Hello and welcome back to Shutter Drives.
If you have seen the dads and siblings, magnite will look familiar. There are a lot of bolt greases racing around the car. The center of attraction is a humongous grill that occupies a lot of real estate. The bi-projector headlamps look ferocious and they are LED streak indicators, just like the way Nissan likes to call it. When you look at it from the side, you realize that it's a compact sub 4-meter SUV with striking 16-inch alloy wheels. Not to forget, the mirrors get a camera underneath them. What's surprising is that the roof rails are actually functional with a load capacity of 50 kgs, which is fantastic considering that it's a sub 4-meter compact SUV. Although Nissan has tried hard to make the rear look as appealing as the front, the design looks underdone in comparison, especially the vanilla non-LED tail lamps and the fake skate plates. Our test car was a 1-liter turbocharged petrol engine. But to cheer things up, Nissan has equipped the magnet with a reverse camera and a parking sensors with rear wipers, which is something to appreciate. Once you open the boot lid, you will actually like the practicality of the magnet, which offers 336 liters of boot space and there is a smaller size spare wheel tucked inside. Once you walk in, you instantly realize that gone are the old school interiors of Nissan, making way to the new funky cabin. The front seats offer good support and are comfortable. You get a huge 10-liter glove box, cup holders, and the tech line is also equipped with a wireless charging pod. However, you will be reminded of the affordable tag once you tap on the plastics, which feel really hard. The steering is adjustable for ache and not reach, where it gets multitude of buttons for music control, voice commands, etc. If you have seen the AC vents of the Lamborghini Urus, these should look familiar. No, we're not even remotely comparing them. The rotary knobs for AC control look classy with the digital numbers inside them. But if there's something that's really worth mentioning is the futuristic 7-inch instrument cluster that seems to be lifted off from a racing game of the 90s. We did have an Instagram poll for the design and the results were very polarizing, which is a concern considering that the magnet is a mass market car. You also get the tire pressure monitoring sensors, which is great. There's a large 8-inch screen that offers multitude of options including 360-degree parking camera, wireless Android Auto and Apple CarPlay, which are first in segment. There's a driving eco mode that scores your driving and provides insight on how to improve on it with some parameters like acceleration and gear shifts. It also displays information like average speed and instantaneous mileage, which is simply clever. The graphics on the reverse camera have a room for improvement. But if there was something that really let us down, it were the exposed parts like the steering rod unit, which should have ideally been neatly covered. To answer the big question that's running on your mind, you don't get the sunroof in any of the variants. More importantly, to control the costs. Surprisingly, the rear seat is spacious with good legroom, headroom, and decent under-thigh support. The rear seat folds in 60-40 split. Although the center passenger will miss out on a headrest, it gets foldable armrest with cup holders and a mobile holder, which is super cool. Before we move out of here, we'll remind you that Magnite is equipped with rear AC vents, which will add a lot of value in the tropical summers of our country.
So this is the Xtronic CVT variant, as Nissan likes to call it. And before we check out how does it fare, a couple of things first. Firstly, you get the dead pedal here, which is adequate in size. And one thing that I want to point out is, in idling, I feel that there are some slight vibrations coming up from the steering. If you observe very closely, you can feel that the steering is slightly vibrating a bit, which is slightly unusual. And let's slot in the drive mode. And here we go. So the power delivery is linear in the initial stages, and mid-range is where you feel there's a lot of punch. and the engine is responsive too. But we felt that the engine gets quite local at higher RPMs. So right now we are just crossing over 4000 RPM and we can actually hear all the voice of the engine coming inside the cabin. That's where we feel that Nissan could have worked a bit upon. Talking about the gear shifts, yes, it's leaps and bounds ahead of the conventional CVT, like the way Nissan claimed. There is very negligible lag when you're changing gears, but then it's a CVT, so you expect that out of it. But any given chance, 10 out of 10 times I would pick this, the Xtronic CVT, over a conventional CVT or a manual gearbox, because the gear shifts are, you know, they are pretty smooth. So when we drove the Nissan Kicks in Bhuj a couple of years ago, we were mightily impressed with the steering feedback of the pure hydraulic power steering that it had. So I set my expectations right when I stepped inside the magnet, and I was mightily impressed. Although the steering is not as heavy as the one in Kicks, but it's pretty direct, it does the job well, absolutely no doubt in that. For example, if you look at the high speed maneuvering around highways, there's no problem. There's not a single moment where you feel nervous when you're overtaking any car at triple digit speeds, or when you're doing sudden maneuvers on the highways at triple digit speeds, which is seriously commendable, unlike the modern joysticks of recent times. So Nissan has added a small sport mode in the drive variant of the Xtronic gearbox, which feels slightly more responsive than the conventional drive mode. Just wanted to add that bit here. And there's a separate L mode, which they say that it's, you know, it's useful when you're probably towing the car, or when you're going down the hill, when the engine wants to run in the most optimum efficiency levels. But they recommend that you do not use that in the daily driving conditions. And one of the things that a lot of you requested in the early reviews was you wanted us to include the horn sound in the review. So here we go. We would have loved if we had the wind tone variant like the one in, you know, Thar or Seltos or Creta. But this is fair enough for city if you're planning a lot of highway trips. We urge that you upgrade to a wind tone variant. And talking about the brakes, although I won't be able to demonstrate the brakes to you in this uncontrolled environment on this highway, on this East Coast road, but we did do some serious braking test some time back, and we found that the braking is good, no doubt, but the pedal is spongy in the initial stages. Overall, pretty good, but definitely not the best. So we are driving the manual variant of the Nissan Magnite now. We have already driven the CVT, which we have discussed in detail. So the first things first, the clutch feels slightly longer in throw. This being a more of a city focused car, we would have preferred if the travel of the clutch was slightly, you know, shorter. And talking about the gearbox, the gear ratios are split nicely, and there's a lot of flow and torque. I mean, there are speeds up to, you know, 35-36 where I'm driving in fourth gear and the car goes on. It doesn't refuse to, you know, it doesn't want to downshift. But having said that, the bigger problem that I feel is the gear shifts are very notchy. I mean, they're pretty hard, especially when you're shifting from the first to second gear. You do feel that, you know, there's a lot of jerk in the gearbox. I think Nissan should have, you know, probably worked on a bit of it where the gear shifts are smoother, considering that this is a city driven car where the gear shifts are going to be more often.
We have always been a fan of how cars from Nissan drive over bad roads. The Terrano ate potholes and craters for breakfast, no matter how it's driven over them. Although the Magnite belongs to the same family, we did find the ride quality to be slightly compromised. It did feel stiff, and the bumps traversed all the way to the driver and passengers. Although it does the job really well when you drive over bad roads at low speeds, we urge you not to get ambitious with the speedo needle here. Never mind, this doesn't get a needle for the speedo either. Having said that, just like any other Nissan, we loved pushing the Magnite around the corners, and there was no nervousness at good triple digit speeds on straight roads. In fact, the stability was fantastic for a small car. Before the digital counter of the speedometer went really high in numbers, we were reminded from the very loud vocals from the rather unrefined 3-port to slow things down. In a nutshell, Magnite is a serious attempt from the Japanese car maker after a slow decade. Nissan says every buyer walking into the showroom will have something catered to his or her requirement. We really hope that the hard work pays off, because if this doesn't sell well for them, nothing else will.
So, going back to where we started off with, can the Magnite live up to its name of being the game changer? We really hope so, because if that doesn't happen, it won't be too long enough before Nissan becomes extinct from India. But having said that, if there's certainly something in their favor, is this super competitive, rumored price tag of 5.5 lakhs, which undercuts all its rivals by a significant margin. But if there's one thing that we are really happy about is that Nissan tried to load in every possible feature in this car to increase the footfalls in the showroom, which shows the commitment of the brand towards this product. More importantly, we are glad that this shaped up as a product from Nissan and not Datsun, which was the initial plan. If you guys like the video, do not forget to subscribe to our channel and follow us on Instagram. Take care, drive safe, and more importantly, stay healthy.